You know that it's fun to go out, except I never leave my house. I'm either at work or home, and it seems kind of pathetic just drinking alone. So if you got nothing going on, have some drinks with Ron.
Welcome to Drinks with Ron. I'm Ron, and this is going to be my drink. The Lazy Mutt Farmhouse Ale. It's from the Minhas Brewery in Monroe, formerly the Huber Brewery, maybe most famous for its Huber Bock, which is still made. I went on a tour there this last weekend, so I'm full of knowledge on the Minhas Brewery, and in fact brought this right from there, directly from there. Bought the corresponding glass, so I can be that guy. It's kind of an unfiltered wheat beer. Somewhat along the lines of a Blue Moon. I like Blue Moon, and I want to be a fan of all these unfiltered wheat beers. I do like a majority of them, but a lot of them are just plain bad. This is not one of those. This is a very good beer. So, yeah, they make a lot of stuff there. The volume that they produce now is insane. I can't remember the stat, like top 5 in the nation or top 10, something like that. Either way, it's ridiculous, their output from what is such a tiny brewery, what they put out, and so many labels. I mean, man, these guys have a ton of stuff. They still kept a lot of their classic old labels, like the Rhinelander, and it said Huber and Huber Bock they still make, but they've come up with some new ones, including Scotty Beer, which frankly, that's a term I've never liked. It comes out of the tongue like, it's a word that sounds like you're chewing cat litter. It's horrible off the palate. It sounds bad to the ear. I've never liked it. But the beer, not too bad. You know, a six pack of the talls. It's only $6.29. It's a good economical price in my area. Not sure if they distribute all throughout the 50 states. They've got a good majority of them on their map. But, yeah. Here it is. You see it? Cloudy. There's shit floating in there. That is quintessential unfiltered wheat beer. Yeah. Even out of a can, which I'm also not a fan of cans, I can taste the aluminum. I don't mind drinking some beers out of cans, but some of them, if I'm drinking, like I say, a good microbrew, top shelf, some specialty seasonal, whatever, it's got to be bottle. But they seem to only have cans there, other than the very large. Oh, I got to show you this one. I had to get two of these bad boys. Chocolate Bunny. It's a stout with, cocoa powder. Kind of like the stouts lately. It's a lot like the Liney's vanilla, Snowdrift Vanilla Porter. Really similar. A little more bitter, actually, than that. What they did at the brewery was they'd give you a cup of this and top it off with just a shot of the cream soda they make there. And, man, that was fucking delicious. That's not so bad itself. I mean, a little hint of the citrus in there. I could go with the orange on top, go the full route and be that guy, but frankly, this stands up on its own. So there you have it. A couple of my recommendations from the Minhas Brewery. I highly recommend you take the tour. Very good. Short tour. You see their production facilities, which are very recycling friendly. They catch every bit of loss and try to turn it into a gain. Very well run place. I mean, efficient as shit. And interesting tour, and they let you sample everything at the end. And man, I sampled my ass off. And you come away with a free glass, which I didn't bring down. It's about like this, a little bit smaller and frosted. It's a Huber glass. Really cool. They send you out with a mixed 5-pack of beers, and they leave the open spot to put your glass in on your way out. It's fantastic. I mean, I bought 3 of these chocolate bunnies, 4-pack of the Lazy Mutt. I think I got I bought this glass. She got a couple of 4-packs of the soda, and the whole thing came to like $23. So, and the brewery tour was $10, and I tell you, I drank way more than $10 worth of beer. I drank close to $10 worth of chocolate bunny and cream soda. Be fucking completely truthful with you. Highly recommend it. Monroe, Wisconsin. $10, take the tour. Check out all the beers there and find out which ones you like. And surprisingly, I liked very, very many of them. So, highly recommend the tour. I will be back and find some Minhas Brewed stuff and give it a try.